What is going on, everyone? Awais here, and today I'm celebrating. I'm gonna share with you something that probably everyone should know, right? If there's one thing you should know about me is that I love the purple color. So much so that several years ago, I actually ended up launching a theme called Shades of Purple. No puns intended. It literally includes all of the shades of purple that I really like. But there was more to it, right? I made this theme in a way that it is consistent across 35 plus languages. It shows the same colors across the, you know, different languages that you are using. And it also has a bunch of amazing features that I'm going to show you just now. But what I'm celebrating today is the fact that more than 3 million developers are using my theme. It is just amazing, right? Even if I was looking at the VS Code extension, the Shades of Purple theme for VS Code, more than 1.5 million active installs. Crazy, right? So, well, there's a reason why lots of developers are choosing to code with this doc theme and not use any other gloomy, you know, doc themes, and they're preferring this theme over others. And let me, you know, let's dive deep into what that reason is. I can't really show you a lot about that, but let's, here's an example, right? This is a markdown file, as you can see. If I write in a heading and start, you know, sharing something like Shades of Purple is pretty, let's say pretty, come on, only if I can type, pretty awesome, right? And now if I go ahead and bold the word awesome, you will start to see that the syntax is basically not getting in your way of reading this markdown, as well as the fact that, you know, the word awesome is actually now bold, right? Also, this heading delimiter, the hash behind the heading, it's also pretty hidden. The same is true for something like code, right? Let's say I'm writing code, three backticks, and then let's say it's JavaScript code. As you can see, these backticks, they used to, you know, literally mess with my head, but in this theme, they are pretty well hidden, right? So when you're writing a lot of markdown, you would love this theme. You know, you would really enjoy the entire experience of writing with this theme. But that's not all, right? There's so much more to it, right? For example, if you see, if there's a color of a particular variable, you will see that color to be consistent across no matter what language you are using, right? And on top of that, I just launched a super dark mode for super late night code runs, right? So go ahead, try it out. If you go to shadesofpurple.pro, you can actually sign up. And, you know, I'll let you know when I am going to launch something pretty awesome, right? Go ahead, open up your VS Code, search for Shades of Purple, install it. If you go to shadesofpurple.pro/more, you can see all the different software that this theme is completely freely available for, right? Like you can install it for Item 2, for Zersh, Hyper, Chrome, Alfred, you name it, right? Especially like the Chrome theme, I see 3,000 plus people are using it already. You can already see it on my Chrome here. I think that's pretty amazing, right? So now you know, lovely jubbly. I am Awais, and this was 1 Dev Minute.